Sri Satpathy.
Thank you, sir. This is a very interesting bill, the Trafficking of Persons Prevention, Protection and Rehabilitation Bill 2018. I find primarily two headlights focusing in two directions. The bill seems to have two main angles. First is rehabilitation of unwanted bureaucrats, either at the state level or at the center, who will be adjusted in various committees, anti-trafficking committees. That is part A. Part B is giving excessive power to the cops to search, seizure, rescue, investigation, evidence, presumption as to offences. The very first page itself focuses on two angles. But along with that, we've had a letter, I think all honourable MPs have received a letter from no less a person than Mr. Satyarthi, supporting and exhorting the MPs to support the bill that Mrs. Maneka Gandhi will bring forth. We would have anyway done it because no matter what we say, the bill will be passed. But let me at the outset say that this bill, although the intention is extremely good, it is having a lot of lapses and it should have a proper review, which it deserves. And we are not doubting your intentions, ma'am. Your intentions are good, but the bill does not have, for example, it does not focus on human rights, or it is not a victim-centric approach bill. It lacks in these two things. Mostly the stress is on criminal law perspective. For example, focus on rescue, raids, rehabilitation, institutionalization of victims under garb of rehabilitation instead of protection. None of us can claim that we are unaware of what happened in that Muzaffarpur shelter a few days ago. Even the government of Bihar was compelled to admit that the helpless girls who were housed there were being exploited physically, and a lot of injustice was meted out to them. And there was no quarter they could approach for help. So this is not something one can politically wave off, and we know you are not dealing with this as a political subject, because if you say that, then Bihar just so happens to be governed by the party which is in power at the center. I will refer to this Buddha Dev Karmakar versus State of West Bengal case, in which the Supreme Court constituted a panel to examine legal issues in relation to prevention of trafficking, rehabilitation of sex workers to leave sex work, conditions conducive for sex workers to live with dignity. This was exclusively for sex workers. I am not going into that aspect. But one of the key recommendations of the panel was to adopt community-based rehabilitation. Unfortunately, this bill badly lacks on that aspect, and it completely sort of ignores that aspect. There is mostly, as I read through the bill, and it's quite a big bill, it took me some time to comprehend the language. It has very high levels of surveillance built into it. No, the bill is a copy, as Mr. Mehtab says, the bill is virtually a copy of an American bill, the Immoral Traffic Prevention Act 1956, which the US probably, they have thrown it to the dustbin, and one of our bureaucrats must have gone on a jaunt to Washington DC, would have picked it up and presented it to the Honorable Minister. Ma'am, this is my creation. So since the language also is a little confusing, If you see section 20 VII, it is all surveillance in the garb of rehabilitation. Bill says that police officers can, on mere suspicion that someone is being trafficked, conduct a raid and rescue operation. The bill also authorizes closure of premises which are to be used as a place of trafficking, which my earlier speakers have also mentioned. And these premises can include land, farm, home, factory, movable property. That means, suppose there is a public transport bus, then the police officer can even seize a bus, say, claiming that this might traffic people who have been clandestinely brought in. I have an issue especially with this because I come from the state of Orissa. And in Orissa, we have a lot of migrant labor. I'll give an example. The Economic Survey of India 2017 estimates that the magnitude of interstate migration in India was close to 9 million annually between 2011 and 2016. While Census 2011 says that total number of internal migrants in the country, accounting for inter and intrastate, at a staggering 139 million people. The vague nature of the bill may lead to the criminalization of all irregular migrants. And Odisha might face acute problems because the Supreme Court also says that when you have anybody being paid less than the minimum wages, that is to be considered as forced labor. So if you see the migrant labor, a lot of our laborers, both women and men, are brought to more economically advanced states like Punjab, where they do farm work, and after the season is over, the cropping season is over or the harvesting season is over, they go back home. But then there are middlemen who organize this in liaison with the big farmers of Punjab. If this law is left to the mercy of the police and the courts, then there is a probability that we will eventually be nabbing and seizing the properties of the farmers, nabbing these middlemen, and stopping the flow of migrant labor, which is essential for even developed states. So I do not know how it will be used, because like I have said this earlier many times and many learned members have also mentioned it, that we merrily sit passing laws in this house thinking that our intentions are good and the good intentions will be will be telecast. Nowadays everybody is onto television. People also complain why the camera is looking at the deputy speaker and not looking at the speaker. So let us say it is telecast down at the grassroots level in a very weird, in a very perverted manner. So to take an overall view of the issue now, this is a very sensitive issue and I will not have the courage to say that the bill is wrong in its intentions or with the motives of the government, but it is something done, I would put it, done haphazardly without proper research. For example, if you consulted NGOs, now I have my reservations about NGOs because in my constituency, in one block called Gondia, there are something like 9,700 something odd NGOs. So I'm very scared of NGOs. They will show all the MGNREGS work, take pictures, take videos, bring some people there and send it to I don't know which organizations and get funded for that also. So NGOs are very creepy, are very doubtful in nature. Instead, when it concerns workers, it would have been appropriate to consult labor unions also, trade unions also. But unfortunately, even in the list that the Madam Minister read out, there was no mention of trade unions being consulted, because this also concerns workers. So labor law perspective has been something that, well, states like Jharkhand, states like Orissa, which contribute to the growth of the nation, not only now, but from, I don't know, 70 years, somebody said we've been independent since 70 plus years, I'm told, according to you. So Jharkhand, Orissa, all the eastern states have contributed, including Bihar and Bengal, right through from freight rationalization period till today. We are only giving. We are only giving to the country. But the country, whether it be Maharashtra or Punjab, they are only taking. They are very, very humble people. So I would suggest that this bill, sir, that this bill be sent to a committee, and a fresh opinion be sought on this, and there should be no ego issue in this. We fully support the bill, but we would like that it be fine-tuned and it be brought back again for a speedy passage in the House. Thank you.